Yes, students. Today we are going to discuss about chapter 2 polynomials, exercise 2.1. Students, for any polynomial, the exponent of variable should be positive or it should be a whole number. Like in exercise 2.1, in your first sum he is asking you whether the given statements are polynomial or not. In first part, this is 4x square minus 3x plus 7. Yes, it will be a polynomial in one variable, because here the power of x is 2, here power of x is 1, here this is 7, so there is no problem in the statement, it is yes. In second part, statement is y square plus under root 2, this is also yes, because there is no problem in the statement, this is a polynomial in one variable. Problem lies with third part, statement is 3 under root t plus t under root 2, this is no, because here exponent of t is under root means 1 by 2 in first term. So power is rational. There should be no rational power in the polynomial, right? If there is rational power, it will not be a polynomial. In fourth part, statement is y plus 2 upon y. This is also no, because exponent of y is minus 1 in the second term. 2 upon y means 2 into y raised to power minus 1. In fifth part, this, yes, it is a polynomial, but it is not in one variable. It is in three variables. Is it clear to you? See all the five parts. Hurry up. Yes, students. In sum number 2, is asking you to write the coefficient of x square in every statement. Like in first part, 2 plus x square plus x. What is the coefficient of x square? Coefficient of x square is, here there is no number. If there is no number with x square, it means coefficient is 1. There is supposed to be 1. Clear? In second part, 2 minus x square plus x cube. What is the coefficient of x square? If there is no number, there is supposed to be 1. It means this is minus 1. Clear? Now in third part, pi by 2 x square plus x. What is the coefficient of x square? What is the coefficient of x square? This is pi by 2. Clear? In fourth part, there is no statement containing x square. It means if there is no statement of x square, it means there is no x square. So coefficient of x square will be 0. Clear to you? Now in sum number 3, he is asking you to write a binomial of degree 35 and a monomial of degree 100. 9th standard, binomial means two terms in the statement. Degree 35 means power of variable should be 35. Highest power of variable should be 35. So I am giving you an example of binomial. Binomial of degree 35 is 2 x raised to power 35. This is your first term plus 7. You can write 7x as well. No problem. Clear? Plus 7x. So these are two terms. And highest power of variable is 35, means degree is 35. What is degree? Highest power of variable. Now in second part, monomial of degree 100. Monomial means one term. Degree means power of variable. Highest power of variable should be 100. Right? You need to write only one term with power 100. So I am writing here y power 100. If you want to write any number with y, you can write. You can write 3. So this is 3y raised to power 100. Clear? See sum number 2 and 3 clearly. Yes, students. Now in sum number 4, he is asking you to write the degree of the statements of the polynomials. In first part, statement is 5x cube plus 4x square plus 7x. You need to write the degree. Students, what is the degree? What is degree? Degree is highest power of variable. Highest power of variable in the statement. Clear? In first part, 5x cube plus 4x square plus 7x. What is the highest power of variable? This is 3, so degree will be 3. In second part, 4 minus y square. what is the highest power of variable? Variable is 1, highest power is 2, so degree is 2. In third part, 5t minus 107, variable is t and highest power of t is, if there is no power of variable, they are supposed to be 1, so degree will be 1. In fourth part, statement is 3 only, there is no variable. It means degree will be 0 because there is no variable in the statement, so the degree of polynomial will be 0. Clear? In sum number 5, it is asking you to classify whether the given polynomial is quadratic, cubic or linear. In first part, statement is x square plus x. This question depends upon degree. If degree is 2, it will be quadratic. If degree is 1, it will be linear. If degree is 3, it will be cubic. Like in first part, x square plus x, degree is 2. Degree is highest power of variable. Degree is 2, it means it is a quadratic. See, quadratic because degree is equal to 2. This is because. In second part, x minus x cube. This is cubic because its degree is 3. Highest power of x is 3. In third part, y plus y square plus 4. This is quadratic because its degree is 2. Clear? Highest power of variable is 2. In fourth part, this is 1 plus x. This is linear because degree is 1. In fifth part, this is 3t. Highest power of variable is 1. Power of t is 1. So this is linear. In sixth part, r square, highest power is 2, so this is quadratic. In last part, 7x cube, highest power of variable is 3, so it will be cubic. See all the parts thoroughly.